Hollywood is not here today, but we talked briefly. Waste Use has a challenge grant out to look at opportunities to activate spaces. We talked when Hollywood came here, they want to create, quote unquote, a people street at their new development. You know, they're developing the old Antlers Funeral Home site into affordable housing and the old Globe Theater site into mixed use housing. So between those two developments, they want to close it and make it, quote unquote, a street for people to hang out and be, and we would help program. Those are important because, you know, we created a people street in the MERT. The bid for the MERT actually manages, makes people clean. Our team few people would do that and monitor it. But we're partnering with them on an application, and we need to get your vote to support that. What we did negotiate, the grant's only $13,000. But they want to give the majority of it, if not all of it, to the bid to handle the outreach. And that's another dollar amount we said we look at additional resources. And that could be for our outreach ambassadors who pass out the information, tell everybody about it, get them to come to the meeting. So they would like to give us that money, put it on our website, which would be about 13 of it, minus some money they have for renderings. So just ask that you agree to support the application. Then once the People Street application comes out from DOT, we would apply to that for a permanent installation. And we're still looking to the Gray Street people to see if they'll approve it because it's kind of off the corridor, but we're hoping that they will.
So full disclosure, we've at CRC just started talking over the last couple of days about submitting an amended application for the same application. Proposal for the same application probably would not involve central action. I wanted to see if this was going forward. If it wasn't, I was going to suggest that we partner on that. But we might apply for something on Washington.
That's a different corridor, so that's great.
But I actually think that this particular application is more competitive because they're giving priority to streets that have been designated as creations.
Yeah. And just a side note, I went with Danny to City Hall to introduce him to people because he's looking at creating a restaurant on site, so I wanted to help him, you know, look at how to get that done. And we ran into Sandra. Are you working with Sandra in Washington?
No, not on this particular
one. Okay, so you probably should be because I talked to her. She just had a grant from Metro, and their grant is to look at activating spaces from the from the transit through 1 mile, last mile. So she can actually look at the entrance from Washington to here, landscaping, beautification. She also has the rights to do, we'll talk about this in the resiliency plan, work on Metro land. So you know that Metro train track. She said she'd be willing to work with us. That's parking that we can activate and green space it. And right next door to that is, as you've seen on your list, Hot Chocolate Development is a manufacturing site. They want to convert that manufacturer over 120,000 square feet into live workspace. And then next door to that is Benji's building. And he's another owner that's agreed to reimagine his space. And he has a space next door, he's looking at parking, but also wants to do live workspace there. So that'll be between Metro, Hot Chocolate, and Benji. You have a nice area. So Sandra's going to come, she wants to come to our meeting and partner with us on that. So, okay, I'm sorry, I digress. So do we have support for this? As a nonprofit, you should always get support from your board for submitting applications for funding. That's something I would recommend, so that's why we're asking to vote on whether or not we can actually submit the application.
We partner with Hollywood Community Housing to submit the grant application for a street, what was it called?
Street place.
That's the people street or street place.
community space.
Yeah, I called it a community space, but we didn't name it yet.
Is it a pop-up? How long?
So the 13,000 is just to imagine what if it's a pop-up.
It's a pop-up.
And it's going to be our prelude to going after the people street money once that comes on board. So you've got to do your outreach, get your community on board, show your design elements. And their architect, by the way, we've asked them to look at activating the sidewalks all around 15. So they're going to look at that. So it's not just
activating.
So the people street will start like a little 20 feet back, but we want people to see it like the sidewalks we create going.
So also full disclosure, a place called Home is also looking at possibility of applying, and has been approached by other organizations, but might be open to partnering on this instead.
For Central Avenue?
For Central Avenue.
Okay, so what, you mean on?
Last year we did the pop-up, and we combined it with our annual Health and Garden Expo, which we do anyway, and so it ended up attracting a couple thousand people, and it was a good synergy. So we're looking at the possibility of piggybacking again, doing something like that, because we do that larger entity there. So we'd be interested in just talking about whether there's a way to participate.
That would be great, because.
It's not about the money, it's not a lot of money.
13,000, so why not activate that in this space? I mean, and again, Hollywood doesn't care about the money either, that's what they're saying is yours. They just wanna make something happen, so if you could you be the program manager? They're developers.
Right, so I just think we just.
We'd be safety and cleaning.
Sit and talk about it. And when, do you know when?
It's due coming up soon.
No, I mean, when to actually do the event?
Oh, we would plan that in our, so we can plan it for around your April 22nd.
Yeah, it's April, it's that Earth Week.
Right, so.
So then why not put in one, so, right, combine like the partner with the place called Home and Hollywood Community Housing, because you said you need them for the development piece?
Well, they don't know how to activate it per se, you know, they just wanna create the space, they want us to look at it, so we can have partner. I mean, CRCD could be a partner, we can act together, really be powerful. I mean, even if you're submitting another application, you can still be a partner. We need the youth involved, all those.
So then I'm saying, my motion is, why don't all y'all just all get together?
Well, that's.
Now, that's a technical motion, that's a technical language, did you get that, Brad? Why don't all y'all just part of May happen? That was the motion, no, seriously.
I'm dragging my back, I'm gonna come close.
Okay, all right.
So why don't I put it this way then? That I move that the board members, that we authorize the board members to create a partnership with whichever organizations they deem relevant to apply for the.
Community space.
Community space grant.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, it's been so moved about the partnership. Second? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Is anyone abstaining? Okay, so.
This is a pop-up, right? Just a pop-up.
Yes.
Okay, and so it's been moved and seconded that we create the partnership with our board members, some of our board members and the Hollywood community to apply for, okay, and approve to apply for the community space on 35th Street. Okay?
Great. And we have some drawings of single multi guide, that the architect has finished, so I'll forward those over. Real brief, CRCD Enterprise is not here. We just got their reports for, reports for August and September, yesterday and today. We're incorporating that, I think the executive committee, you received a link from Griffin incorporating them, and we have some other, the branding and stuff to finish up. That'll be your quarterly report, but we do have their reports in, and I will have to share those with you. We just got those, but we did share them with the executive committee.
What's your email report?
So that's from August and September, so they were to get us the, by the 15th of the month, so they should have been September, by September and, yeah, September and October reports. Yeah, we did get their invoice today as well, which we had made a policy, not a policy, whatever, that we would hold on to those. We wouldn't pay them until we got those reports, but, and as you know, they work with Griffin to redefine the reports, so they're much better. We've got to correct, we have to quantify what they do, how much graffiti, how many bags of trash, how much.
The invoice we got today, was that for the current month or the previous month?
So that was an invoice for August and September.
Okay, so can, maybe we should just have a rule that they have to deliver a report around.
That's what I, yeah. So even if they had sent the invoice, but we wouldn't pay them.
No, I get it.
We just got it today, you know. But I guess they didn't send it today, we weren't gonna.
But I mean, to me, it just seems like them getting paid really isn't the issue, because if it was, then we would get the reports immediately.
No, the issue is, just to be fair, and again, Griffin and I have been working with them on the reporting system. You know, they have a larger contract with City they were feeding into that system trying to figure out how they pull out, so it wasn't feasible. So we work with them to restructure. They have a person who's there, work with her on Excel, so we're working through the problem, and I think it's better. The other thing that we've done is by having the ambassadors and Alan, we have their spot checking. So graffiti comes up, Alan sends CRCD a picture, and that's how we're dealing with it. Or if the trash can is overflowing, or the sidewalk's done, we sent them a message on Halloween night. We said, hey, you had a big party last night, y'all got some cleaning up to do. So we're coordinating with them on a tactic. We'll talk about that too. So we're more tactical, move them off of our plan is to clean the sidewalk today, tomorrow we're doing this one. No, let's be tactical. We've identified the bad spots, and so that's how we're moving it forward. So, and there has been a lot of extra PD, I don't know what's going on in the community, but we've asked for meetings with LAPD to address that as a separate issue. So that's on the clean streets, and I'm going to let the ambassadors do their presentation.
Ambassadors at Warren Central.
Well, we grew up in the same apartment building. We went to the same high school. He's my homie.
Good evening. My name is Curren Price, and I'm a part of the ambassador.
Thank you.
And I'm Johnny Veal.
Hi, I'm Victor.
Yes.
That's the team.
Good team you are.
Good job.
So they activated their very first event, and our graphics person, David Morrison, did the design. Oh, we forgot their bags. Oh, you got it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. did the design of your bags. We had cards to announce the holiday, the Halloween trick-or-treat. And then we also had a card to announce all the businesses that had costumes. We circulated 5,000 of the announcement card and 10,000 of the other cards. And what had happened was, this is what I have to explain this, the ambassadors not only covered the entire quarter, but they rode from San Pedro to Hooper, up and down all the streets, all the way up to 48th Street. Now, what had happened was, there were so many people on this corridor.
I was going to tell you that. I was coming home last night. I was like, there's a lot of people out here.
Oh, my God. It was way too successful. We ran out of candy in a nanosecond. Of course, the council office did not bring us our candy, but even if they had,
it still would have been out.
So we got our. So you guys are owning, these are your bags. You guys own Halloween as far as I'm concerned over here. And we were, and Vivian passed out candy. You guys ran out pretty soon, right? It was ridiculous how many people were here. So we want to ask you, one is next year, we're going to start collecting candy now. You actually spend $400 on candy at the dollar store. So that's like 400 bags of candy. It wasn't enough. And then so the other thing is Giant Steps came, brought their people. We had a few outcomes. Giant Steps brought their team over, and they donated all the clothes for the scarecrows, which came out fabulous, if anybody saw any of them. And go ahead and run your pictures. And so this is from the other, so we had four activations for trick-or-treat, and again, your budget was about $1,500.